你好，我是一鸣老师。Today we are going to learn all the essential adjectives you need to describe clothing. That is something we all use in everyday life. 我们从最简单的开始。Let's start with the easiest ones. First, we have 大 and 小, big and small. So for the size of the clothes, we have 大号, big size.大号 and small size, 小号小号 and the medium size is 中号中号 For example, you are shopping and you tried a t-shirt but it's too big. You can ask a seller,
这件 T 恤太大了，有没有小号的？
This t-shirt is too big. Do you have a small size?
这件 T 恤太大了，有没有小号的？
And we have 长 long and 短 short 短
长 and 短
For example, 长裙 is a dress and 短裙is a skirt. Let's read together.
长裙短裙
Right. 长裙 and 短裙 For example,
这条裙子很好看但是太长了
This dress is very pretty, but it's too long. 条 is a major word for long object. So here when we say这条裙子 So it's probably a dress, not a skirt.
这条裙子很好看但是太长了
Let's read again together.
这条裙子很好看但是太长了
Right. Learn Chinese words and sentences fast with these beautiful, colorful flashcards with fun pictures.Each card teaches you a Chinese word and a very useful sentence with it. Beginner's level also includes audio files. It will make your study more fun and efficient. Both adults and children love them. Instant download after the purchase. Click the link down below in the description box. Now we have 紧, tight.
紧比如说这件毛衣太紧了。
This sweater is too tight. For sweater, we use the major word 件 The most common major word for clothes.
这件毛衣太紧了。
这件毛衣太紧了。And the opposite of tight, loose, is 宽松。宽松。宽 literally means wide.松 is loose, but most of the time we say both of them. We use them together to say loose.
宽松宽松
比如说 You'd better wear loose clothes when you practice yoga.
你练瑜伽的时候最好穿宽松的衣服
So, 最好 do something is a common way to give advice to someone.
你练瑜伽的时候最好穿宽松的衣服
I'll read faster
你练瑜伽的时候最好穿宽松的衣服
Okay, our next word is 新 new 新 Let's see example sentence
我女儿非常喜欢她的新裙子
My daughter likes her new dress very much. Actually, here, the 裙子 could be dress or skirt. So also could be, my daughter likes her new skirt very much. So in Chinese, when you say 裙子, if you don't specify it's 长裙, dress, or 短裙, skirt, it could be either of them.
我女儿非常喜欢她的新裙子。
我女儿非常喜欢她的新裙子。And the opposite of new is
旧 old. 旧 Perhaps you know 老 means old, but 老 normally just refers to age or time. But here 旧 means it's already used, perhaps a color fade or even broken. Let's take a sentence. It's a little long, pay attention.
这些旧衣服你别扔，你可以把它们捐了。
Do not throw away these old clothes. You can donate them. You see, we put
这些旧衣服
these old clothes at the beginning of the sentence. Then comes you don't throw them.
这些旧衣服你别扔，你可以把它们捐了。
One more time.
这些旧衣服你别扔，你可以把它们捐了。
Okay, next word, 干净 clean, 干净。比如说 after taking a bath, she changed into clean pajamas.
她洗完澡，换了一身干净的睡衣。
Here, 一身干净的睡衣，身 you know literally means body, so use 一身 because pajama is a whole set, includes the upper part and the pants. So
一身干净的睡衣。
Let's read it one more time.
她洗完澡，换了一身干净的睡衣。
她洗完澡，换了一身干净的睡衣。And now the opposite of clean is dirty.
脏脏
dirty. For example,
脏衣篮
It literally means dirty clothes basket. It means laundry basket.
脏衣篮
For example,
脏衣篮是我们放脏衣服的篮子
Laundry basket is the basket in which we put our dirty clothing.
脏衣篮是我们放脏衣服的篮子。
Let's read one more time.
脏衣篮是我们放脏衣服的篮子。
Alright, next word is fashionable. It's 时尚。
时尚。
For example, 这件衬衫很时尚。
面料也很好。
This shirt is very fashionable and the fabric is very good.
这件衬衫很时尚，面料也很好。
这件衬衫很时尚，面料也很好。Another example, her clothes are always fashionable.
她的穿着总是很时尚。
穿着 means dress or the way someone dresses.
她的穿着总是很时尚。
她的穿着总是很时尚。Actually, in spoken Chinese, there's a more common way to say someone is very good at dressing. Someone has good fashion sense. It's
她很会穿衣服。
This is much easier.
她很会穿衣服。
她很会穿衣服。And 时尚 also is a noun. It means fashion. For example, she is very interested in fashion. That would be,
她对时尚很感兴趣。
对 something 感兴趣 is a structure to say be interested in something.
她对时尚很感兴趣。
Faster, 她对时尚很感兴趣。Another useful adjective is 休闲 It means casual.
休闲
休 the same 休 with 休息 rest, remember?
休闲 casual.
For example, the clothes in this store are very casual.
这家店的衣服都很休闲。这家店的衣服都很休闲。
Faster,这家店的衣服都很休闲。And the opposite of casual is formal.
正式。正式。
我们 只是去喝咖啡。你不用穿的这么正式。
We're just going for coffee. You don't need to dress so formally.
我们只是去喝咖啡。你不用穿的这么正式。
我们只是去喝咖啡。你不用穿的这么正式。
To say formal clothes is 正装
is short for 正式的服装 formal clothes.
So the shorter way to say it is 正装 formal clothes, 正装。
Okay, that is all the adjectives to describe clothing for today's lesson. I hope you took note and learned something useful, but the most important is practice them. So that's all for today.
谢谢你收看我的视频，那我们下次再见，再见。